always blessed beyond measure. Amen. If you have your Bible, please stand with us this morning. Amen. I saw a video of a lady, old lady, she's 90 years old on social media. She's been on the news at 90 years old singing about wearing a robe and a crown. How many of you saw that? Amen. I watched that boy. She sang it. I wanted to dance with her. Amen. I can tell you, if God lets me tarry on this earth until I'm 90, I pray I'm singing like that with the joy of the Lord in my soul. Amen. I want to say a big thank you to Brother John. He did a wonderful job conducting the services on Sunday and preaching Sunday night. Amen. Wonderful, my brother. Brother Jonathan did a great job Sunday morning. Amen. And I heard Sister Tina just preached the house down on Wednesday night. Man, I think we may have some Deborahs out here on. Thank you, sister. I heard so many wonderful reports. If you have your Bible, please turn to 2 Samuel chapter 16, verse 5. Amen. The Lord put this up on my heart, and I began to study this out, and it began to knit some things together. It's going to take a while. We may jump right out the chute running, but we'll just believe God to paint the right picture. How many of you know God wants to save you? Amen. He wants to save you, but He also wants you to remain in that salvation. 2 Samuel chapter 16 and verse 5, we've got a lot of verses to read, so just stay with me. 16, verse 5. And when King David came to Bahurim, behold, thence came out a man of the family of the house of Saul, whose name was Shimei, the son of Gera. He came forth and cursed still as he came. And he cast stones at David and at all the servants of King David and all the people and all the mighty men on his right hand and on his left. And thus said Shimei when he cursed, come out, thou bloody man, thou man of Belial. The Lord hath returned upon thee all the blood of the house of Saul, in whose stead thou hast reigned. And the Lord hath delivered the kingdom into the hand of Absalom thy son. And behold, thou art taken in thy mischief, because thou art a bloody man. Then said Abishai the son of Zerah unto the king, why should this dead dog curse my lord the king? Let me go over, I pray thee, and take off his head. The king said, what have I to do with you, you sons of Zeruiah? So let him curse, because the Lord has said unto him, curse David. Who shall then say, wherefore hast thou done so? David said to Abishai and to all his servants, behold, my son, which came forth out of my bowels, seeketh my life. How much more now may this Benjamite do it? Let him alone, and let him curse, for the Lord hath bidden it. It may be that the Lord will look on my affliction, and that the Lord will requite me good for his cursing this day. And as David and his men went by the way, Shimei went along on the hillside over against him and cursed as he went, and threw stones at him and cast dust. And the king and all the people that were with him came weary and refreshed themselves there. Now if you'd go to 2 Samuel chapter 19 and verse 16. Going to bounce around just a little bit in this chapter. The Bible says, and Shimei, the son of Gerari, Benjamite, which was of Bahurim, hasted and came down with the men of Judah to meet King David. Verse 18, there went over a ferry boat to carry over the king's household and to do what he thought good. And Shimei, the son of Gerar, fell down before the king as he was come over Jordan and said unto the king, let not my lord impute iniquity unto me. Neither do thou remember that which thy servant did perversely the day that my lord the king went out of Jerusalem, that the king should take it to his heart. For thy servant doth know that I have sinned. That's acknowledgement. Therefore, behold, I am come the first this day of all the house of Joseph to go down to meet my lord the king. Verse 23, therefore the king said unto Shimei, thou shalt not die. And the king swear unto him. Now if you'd go to 1 Kings 2:36. The Bible says, and the king sent and called Shimei and said unto him, build thee a house in Jerusalem and dwell there, and go not forth thence any whither. For it shall be that on the day thou goest out and passeth over the brook Kindred, thou shalt know for certain that thou shalt surely die. Thy blood shall be upon thine own head. And Shimei said unto the king, this saying is good, as my lord the king hath said, so will thy servant do. And Shimei dwelt in Jerusalem many days. Somebody say many days. And it came to pass at the end of 3 years that two of the servants of Shimei ran away unto Achish, son of Micah, the king of Gath. And they told Shimei, saying, behold, thy servants be in Gath. And Shimei arose and saddled his ass and went to Gath to Achish to seek his servants. And Shimei went and brought his servants from Gath. It was told Solomon that Shimei had gone from Jerusalem to Gath and was come again. The king sent and called for Shimei and said unto him, did I not make thee to swear by the Lord and protested unto thee, saying, know for a certain on the day thou goest out and walkest abroad any whither, thou shalt surely die. Thou saidst unto me, the word that I have heard is good. Why then hast thou not kept the oath of the Lord and the commandment that I have charged thee with? The king said moreover to Shimei, thou knowest all the wickedness which thine heart is privy to, that thou didst to David my father. Therefore the Lord shall return thy wickedness upon thine own head. And King Solomon shall be blessed, and the throne of David shall be established before the Lord forever. So the king commanded Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, which went out and fell upon him, that he died. And the kingdom was established in the hand of Solomon. How many of you know this morning that you have a choice? I have a choice. I want to preach to you upon this thought, let it go, abiding in divine opportunity. Let it go, abiding in divine opportunity. Would you help me pray? Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to gather in your name. You said, Lord, where two or three are gathered together in your name, there you would be in the midst of them. We believe that, Lord, not only because we feel your presence, but Lord, because we know that you're true to your word. Ask, oh God, that you'd have your way in this house in the name of Jesus. And God's people shouted, amen. You may be seated. Preaching, let it go, abiding in divine opportunity. As we move forward in this message, we will find ourselves on both sides of the proverbial coin. We will first find ourselves in the experience of King David, but we will also find ourselves in the experience of the man Shimei. We understand here this morning that there are seasons, times, and moments that come to the child of God where they literally walk through the valley of the shadow of death. These experiences can come simply by living the Christian life, for Peter said, and if you suffer for righteousness' sake, happy are you. Be not afraid of their terror, neither be troubled. However, it seems that more times than not, a believer's suffering comes through their own wrong decisions, wrong mistakes, and wrong choices. As we look at our text today, we find this reality of life. We find King David not going through difficulty, hardship, and trial because of righteousness' sake, but rather for unrighteousness' sake. Scripture teaches us that David is having to flee Jerusalem because of previous sinful actions. In other words, the environment that David was living in was created by his own choices in life. He couldn't blame his spouse. Can you say amen? He couldn't blame his boss. He couldn't blame his children. He couldn't blame the church. And he sure enough couldn't blame the pastor. David's difficulty rested upon David's own shoulders. We find that it was in this moment of life when David was down, ashamed, and broken that Shimei entered into his life. It says, and when King David came to Bahurim, behold, thence came out a man of the family of the house of Saul, whose name was Shimei, the son of Gerar. He came forth and cursed still as he came. And he cast stones at David and at all the servants of King David. And all the people and all the mighty men were on his right hand and on his left. And thus said Shimei when he cursed, come out, thou bloody man, and thou man of Belial. The Lord hath returned upon thee all the blood of the house of Saul, in whose stead thou hast reigned. And the Lord hath delivered the kingdom into the hand of Absalom thy son. And behold, thou art taken in thy mischief, because thou art a bloody man. Now these verses tells us several things about how the devil comes at those who find themselves in difficulty because of their own sinful actions. How many of you know this morning that you and I, as people of God, can sin? And if you do sin, you will find yourself in environments that are not wonderful to live in. Can you say amen? It is in these environments that we find that Satan approaches the child of God who has repented. And several things here. We find that, one, that Satan uses people to come out against you and I. Secondly, Satan twists former actions to validate an untrue narrative. Thirdly, Satan brings the Lord into the equation to try and bring credibility to the assault. And lastly, Satan challenges spiritual positioning's legitimacy, for Shimei said, you're reigning in Saul's stead. I want you to hear this morning, because I believe in this room many of you have sinned, but you've asked God to forgive you, to wash you, and this has been since you've been converted. But you're living in a world where Shimei is walking along, Sister Donna. He's throwing stones. He's kicking dust. He's challenging the legitimacy of your spiritual positioning. He's saying you are a bloody man. I mean, he's cursing you, and you're saying to yourself in this moment of life, you know what, Shimei, maybe you're right. Maybe God doesn't have anything for me. Maybe I am a dirty dog. Come on, somebody. I said, Maybe you're right, Shimei. But the Lord wanted me to tell you that you have a forgiving God. You have a merciful God, and you can reach Bahurim. You can reach that place. Amen. We understand that when these assaults come, it behooves the child of God to not respond in kind, to not engage, and to not defend themselves, but to simply allow it and keep moving forward, knowing that God is not through with me yet. Hallelujah. I'm thankful that David didn't stop that horse, stop that mule, and say, you know what? There's no reason for me to go on. But he understood, in spite of the cursing, in spite of the stone, in spite of the dust, there's a better day for me if I'll keep walking on with God. There's a refreshing for the child of the Lord. Give him praise in his house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said, the people, David, the Bible said, and his men went by the way. David also said, it may be that the Lord will look on my affliction, and that the Lord will requite me good for his cursing this day. You see, I believe that every child of God can probably relate to David at this point in his life. They know what it feels like to do something wrong and to suffer the consequences for what they have done. However, the child of God does have a forgiving, a merciful, and a compassionate God. 1 John 2:1 says, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. So if we find ourselves suffering for wrong actions, may we simply restrain ourselves and keep on walking with God, trusting Him in all things. You say, Pastor, why is it that some people fall out? They fall out because they don't realize that just up the road, Brother Philip, is a Bahurim, amen. It's a place of refreshing. Hallelujah. It says in the scripture, the king and all the men that were with him came weary and refreshed themselves there. Hallelujah. You say, Pastor, what do you want PAG to be? I want people to walk through those doors and feel like Shimei has cursed them all week because of their failures, but they can come in the house of God and be refreshed. Why? Because that's what God desires for your life. I can tell you I have a controversy, Brother David, with a man that is unrepentant. Amen. You need Shimei. You need to repent of your sin. But David understood. We can read in the book of Psalms when he wrote a psalm in this experience. He was contrite. He was broken. He was repentant. Amen. But you and I know the devil is good at being a Shimei. There's many times I walk through those doors. I've got dust all over me. I've got wounds from the stones of Shimei because I know I did something wrong, but I've got a God that refreshes my soul. Hallelujah to the everlasting God. Glory, glory, glory. Bahurim means young men. We could say that at Bahurim, King David was able to recapture his spiritual youthfulness, passion, energy, and commitment. I've found that few ever make it to the refreshments of Bahurim simply because they can't get beyond the hurtful words of Shimei and stone and dust throwing of him. Because what Shimei says, Dove has a smidge of credibility to it. Did you hear me? David was having to leave Jerusalem. David did have bloody hands. God said he did. David was reigning in Saul's stead. And David was taken in mischief. It would have been very easy for David to throw in the towel, to quit, and to give up because there was some legitimacy to the accusations of hell. Listen to me. The devil doesn't accuse you of things he doesn't have a smidge of credibility. He doesn't say you robbed a bank yesterday when you were at home watching the finals. No, no. He says something to your life that has a smidge of credibility that if he can pull you down and say, you know what, devil, you're right. I don't deserve to be a child of God. I don't deserve to go to Royal Family Kids Camp. I don't listen. You do deserve it. Why? Because God is the forgiver of your sin. Glory. Hallelujah. You see, David didn't, in spite of it all, did not throw in the towel. He just took the insult, took the ridicule, took the cursing, took the accusation, and he took the stoning and just kept moving forward with God, knowing in the depth of his heart that this too shall pass. Listen to me. If you'll just keep coming to church, Pastor, you don't know what I did. David committed murder, committed adultery, lied about it. Oh, you're not hearing me. I said David did a lot of evil wickedness, amen. Everything in him, the devil's probably whispering in that ear, Brother Mike, saying you just need to turn that around and face the consequences of your sin. But he just kept his head low and said, Lord, I know I don't deserve it. I know I don't deserve it. I know I don't deserve it. But thanks be to God, there's a Bahurim. May PAG be a Bahurim for you. Not a place where you get pushed back down, but a place that God can minister to your soul. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank God for his goodness. See, we understand that at this moment, we are all thinking of that one person in our lives that we can say, that is my Shimei for sure. Come on, somebody. However, I submit that Shimei is all of us. Turn to your neighbor and say, that's you. Shimei is a type of every man, woman, boy, and girl upon the face of this planet. Shimei is the fallen nature of mankind. The nature that despises Christ, ridicules Christ, and abhors Christ as a usurper to its own evil rule. Though this is true, as Shimei, Christ has shown great grace and mercy to the sinner. 1 Corinthians 6:11, my favorite verse in the Bible, at least one of them, and such for some of you. But you are washed, but you are sanctified, but you are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of God. 2 Samuel 19:16, and Shimei the son of Gerar, a Benjamite, which is of Bahurim, hasted and came down with the men of Judah to meet King David, and said unto the king, let not my lord impute iniquity unto me, neither do thou remember that which thy servant did perversely the day that my lord the king went out of Jerusalem. How many of you would testify? If I could go back, I'd take a lot of things back I said to Brother Jeremy about Jesus. I remember one time he came to witness to me and some of my friends, and I questioned everything he said about the Bible. Can I get a witness? He had one of those one books that, you know, if you're happy, you know, it gives you happy verses, or if you need peace, it gives you those. I looked at that little book, and I said, man, that's not even the Bible. Oh, don't look at me funny. If you could go back too, I'm sure you wouldn't have said that about Jesus either. I look at Brother Marty. Brother Marty was backslid for a long time. Surely you said things about the Lord and the church that you regret today. We all have those things. But thanks be to God who doesn't impute iniquity but throws it to the sea of forgetfulness and says, I know, buddy, you cursed me all the day long. You cursed me on the cross. You cursed me, but I'm willing to forgive you. I'm willing to forgive you. It says in verse 23, therefore the king said unto Shimei, thou shalt not die. And the king swore unto him. 1 Kings 2:36, and the king Solomon sent and called for Shimei, said unto him, build thee a house in Jerusalem, dwell there, go not. Somebody say, stay put. Fence any with her. As we look at this verse in 1 Kings 2:36, there are several things that I would like to convey. One, the greatness of invitation in spite of former actions. We must realize in this statement where Solomon said, it says of Solomon rather, the king sent and called for Shimei. You see, Shimei did not come to Solomon upon his own inclination, but rather, the king sent and called for Shimei, offering him divine life instead of divine death. It is as if Solomon was saying throughout all of Israel, Adam, where art thou? Shimei, I know that you rebelled against Christ. I know, Shimei, that you spoke against the Lord and you lived against the person of Jesus. However, in spite of your actions, I, the king, I am still calling. I am still sending. I am still reaching. It says in 1 Peter, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You see, Solomon was calling Shimei out of darkness and into the light of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. He was saying to Shimei, I know you're in darkness, but I'm calling you, pal, into the light of the everlasting gospel. This calling was not based upon Shimei's own merit, but rather upon the mercy, the grace, and the forgiveness of King Solomon. Oh, of all the invitations in the Bible, surely this one is at the top. You and I may look upon our actions as unforgivable, as Shimei must have, as he threw rocks and threw stones at David. However, it doesn't matter what we have done, what we have said, what stones we have thrown, or what dust we have kicked up against Christ and his church. There is one greater than Solomon. whose invitation goes beyond the degree of your sin. Jesus said, come unto me, all you that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. It says in one able commentary, not only did David forgive Shimei and Solomon have him a place in Jerusalem, David applied his forgiveness by rejecting the counsel of his nephew Abishai and graciously forgave the groveling Shimei. Hallelujah. Do you not realize whenever Shimei was doing that, all the men with David said, take off his head. But I'm thankful that David doesn't listen to the religious world. He doesn't listen to that human nature. He says, I'm not going to listen to you, but I'm going to forgive Thomas Gerardo. I'm going to forgive Lori. I don't care, devil, what you say. I've got a plan for their life. Glory! You know, if it was up to the devil, you'd already be dead. Devil looks at you and I. He looks at us as the people of God. He says, why don't you take off their head? Look how they curse you, Jesus. Look how they're unfaithful to you. Oh, but the Lord has a closed ear to the religious. Well, that's enough to make you run around this building. Glory! Hallelujah. You see, we find that Shimei's invitation was substantiated with allotment and provision. Solomon said, build thee a house in Jerusalem and dwell right there. In other words, Solomon's invitation towards Shimei was not fragile or faulty, but strong, permanent, and settled in the heavens. Solomon did not want Shimei to sleep on the street, to stay in the shelter, or stay in the Jerusalem motel. No, no. Solomon wanted Shimei to build him a house. He wanted Shimei to feel safe, secure, and comfortable within the walls of Jerusalem. Oh, glory. The word build means to establish, build up, and to cause to continue. He wanted Shimei to know, Sister Daquita, that this salvation, this forgiveness is something that is fixed. It is something that is eternal. Solomon didn't say, Shimei, come sit and sleep on the streets of Jerusalem, but get you a stone, get you a door, get you a window, and set up shop, pal. I want you to be here forever. I can tell you, when you really get salvation, you feel the credibility of it. When I got saved, I didn't feel like one moment Solomon wanted me to stay at night and get lost. How many of you felt like, you didn't feel like that? How many of you are saved? I'm watching. You say, Pastor, I'm saved. Well, then Solomon says to you this morning, get inside the walls of Jerusalem and build up your faith. Hallelujah. Build up yourself in the most holy faith. Get the stone, but you're here to stay, friend. You have every opportunity to stay in Jerusalem forever. But you also have opportunity to leave when you want. I said, you also have opportunity to leave whenever you want. You say, Pastor, what is God looking for? He's looking for a people that no longer, somebody say no longer, no longer go out. Revelation 3:12, him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go out no more. I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of that holy city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down from heaven from my God, and I will write upon him my new name. In other words, Jesus is saying, I want you in Jerusalem, not only on your time on earth, but in that sweet by and by, that you always abide under the shelter of his wings. But you also must know, God ain't going to chain you in. God ain't going to tie you down. God ain't going to throw you in a cell to get you to heaven. I want you to hear me. Is salvation free? Yes. Can you get it with your own works? But it is maintained by your obedience. Solomon told Shimei, come to Jerusalem. What an invitation. Come on to me, all you that are heavy laden. I will give you rest. He said, come on to me, Shimei. Build right next door to the king's palace. But God's not going to keep you in here. Neither am I. I learned a long time ago, Brother Larry, I don't beg people to be a part of the kingdom of God. That's not my responsibility. My responsibility, Brother David, is to say unto all the world, there's a place for you in Jerusalem. Come. But do I have to buy property there, Sister Stephen? No, it's free. Aren't you glad Solomon didn't say, now that piece of land you're trying to build on there, Shimei, is going to cost you $150,000.29. He said, I don't much want to go there. Come on, somebody. It's free. Somebody say, free. 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 But God's not going to make you stay in Jerusalem. There is a condition to the salvation, the forgiveness. Shimei, you can build right there. But under no circumstance are you to walk out of that city. Somebody say, nothing. Nothing. For no reason are you to walk out of Jerusalem. Because in the day that you do, you forfeit your rights of forgiveness. Is it free? You bet your bottom dollar it's free. Can you work to get salvation? No. But the Bible says, Jesus said it best actually, abide in me and I in you. In other words, Solomon was saying, you are safe, Shimei, as long as you are in Christ. That's it. For 3 years, Shimei sat on the front row. He sat on the front row and praised the Lord, listened to the preacher. Oh, this is great. I love forgiveness. Oh, I love living in Jerusalem. Look at all the peace and the joy. My sins are forgiven. But after 3 years, something happened. What happened? Two servants bolted. Oh, for 3 years it was bliss in the church. No trials, no temptation. I mean, glory. Wonderful. Wonderful, Bo. He got baptized just like you did in Jerusalem. I'm sure he did. What a wonderful experience of God. But after 3 years, he got wind of something. Somebody's been talking about him in the church. Oh, you're not hearing me. Fix your crown. After 3 years, he got sick in body. After 3 years, somebody on the job did him wrong. After 3 years, his kid. After 3 years, he loved Jerusalem. But after 3 years, Brooke, something happened when he went to college. You hear me, kids? He loved Jerusalem, abided in Jerusalem. But Solomon said, the day you leave this city for any reason, well, God, you just don't know what they did to me. I don't care. Come on, somebody. For any reason, Shimei, do you got it? Let's get it very clear to you. Solomon laid it out as clear as he could. For any reason, do you get it, Shimei? Anyone? I got it, and it seems good to me, what Shimei said. That's perfect. I got it. Have you ever told your kids something like you really told them? They're like, I got it. And you come back and they're like, you didn't get it. Shimei, I got it. But maybe he went to a church one Sunday morning that said, you don't really have to stay in there. Maybe he went somewhere. Someone on social media said, now Shimei, you got every reason to get angry and mad. Shimei, you've got those
servants belong to you. You gonna let them dirty dogs do that to you? Oh, come on, somebody. Two servants. Maybe they were his two all-stars on his ball team. He needed them two to win the game. He said, if it was the B team squad, I'd just let them go. But this here, these are, this is, I, we can pay for college with them two. I can see him debating in his mind. I know what Solomon said. I know what that book says, Brother B. I know what it says in that book. To stay in Christ, abide in me, I in you. I know what it says. You on the back rows? You know what it says. Abide in me, I in you. That's what the Bible says. I don't care what you think. I don't care what you say you believe. It's what the Word of God says. Abide in Christ. Period. You die outside of Christ, you're dead. Eternally. Shimei, I thought to himself, I'm going to slip out. I'm going to come back. You see, Solomon highlighted the Kidron Valley because you know why? The Kidron Valley was the way to Shimei's old life. He had to cross that to get to Jerusalem from where God called him out of. Now he's got to cross it. You know what he's doing? He's exchanging life back for death. I'm just going to go tell them people off, and then I'm going to get right back in here. Oh, come on, somebody. Well, I've been gone too long. He said, I'm just going to tell them off. I'm just going to watch that. I'm just going to say that. I'm just going to have my little attitude, and I'm going to get back in like last time I slipped out the door. Come on now. I can tell you, we all have servants that bolt on us. Plans bolt. Jobs bolt. People bolt. Emotions bolt. And some of you this morning, you're brewing. I've got to stay in Christ, but boy, if I could get out of here, I'd whip him to a pulp. Come on, somebody. Come on. Boy, if they just knew me before I got into Jerusalem. You see, Shimei let the best, worst of him get the best of him. He said, man, I'm going to saddle my ass. I'm going to ride as fast as I can. And I'm going to get them dirty dogs. And I'm going to come right back on Sunday night. Pastor won't even know I've been gone. Come on. I'm going to do it real quick like. After 3 years, the devil got him. Listen to me. We all have servants. And they all going to bolt. Say they going to bolt. They going to bolt on you. But what you do when they bolt. Paul said it best like this. I count it all but loss. You know what Paul's saying? Every day I come outside this wall and two more servants bolt. That attitude bolts. That desire bolts. That bolts and that bolts and that bolts and that bolts. And I'm left with absolutely nothing of a natural way. But let me tell you, to live for Christ is gain. Hallelujah. Let that servant bolt out the door. I don't care what the world tells me, sends me back. Did you know your servants bolted, Robin? Yeah, I know it. But I count it all joy for the excellency. My God, let it bolt today. Let it bolt tomorrow. I'm staying in Jerusalem, giving praise in this house. Glory! You know what the difference of people that remain saved and people that backslide? They go after bolted servants. Did you hear me? I said they go after bolted servants. There comes a day where they think they need to take things in their own hands. Let me tell you, if God wants some servants to come back, He knows you're to be in Jerusalem. Brother John, if God wanted them servants to come back to Shimei, you know what happened? They'd come back. God wants me in Jerusalem with Shimei. But I can tell you, if it bolts out those city walls, it's not for you. Listen, young people. If that relationship bolts, don't cry over it. What are you doing? What are you doing? If it's of God and it's for you, it'll stay in Jerusalem in Christ. Listen, don't go chasing careers and jobs and Lord knows whatever else. Chase that stuff. What are you saying? You'll chase it right out of Jerusalem. And when you think you're just going to prance right back in with your goods, there's going to be a Solomon that's going to meet you at the door and say, pal, you fully understood, Elizabeth. But if you walk out of here for any reason, then that life that you were granted is going to come to death. Life was only given, Brother Jerry, only given to Shimei because he stayed in Christ. Listen, you don't toy with salvation. You don't mess with it. You don't think I'm just going to ride out of here and I'm going to live like the devil for 2 weeks and come back in church act like nothing's the same. You listen to me. Don't you go chasing servants. This place should be packed full of people, but you know where they are? They're out looking for servants, but what they don't realize is they may never make it back. Do you know how many people said, I'm going to chase these servants, and I'm going to come back and be full of God, and I'm going to really get in? And folks, there's a lot of them. There's a lot of them. They said what the devil's telling you right now, just go get those servants. Do you notice that it was nobody in Jerusalem, Brother Jeremy, that told Shimei about these servants? Nobody in Jerusalem did that. Who told him that? Word got to him from Achish of Gath. The world told him that. His pastor didn't tell him to go after servants. The Holy Ghost didn't tell him to do that. The world did. He said, folks, go ahead and stand with me. Folks, how many of you heard the world send word back to you and say, yeah, oh yeah. You know what they're saying about you on that job? Do you know what they're doing? Do you know what they said about you in church? Do you know what they said? You know what they're doing to you? You know what the devil's trying to do to you, Brother Shane? He's trying to get you to leave Jerusalem and chase after servants. Not because you don't necessarily want to live in Jerusalem. Shimei didn't want to move. He just wanted to recapture something. God wanted to be lost forever. You hearing me? Sister, Lord God's talking to you, sister. Listen. When those servants bolt and the devil says, go after them and come back. Listen, if God wanted them to stay in your life, he would let them stay forever. Did you hear me? Let God the Holy Ghost keep you in Jerusalem. Because in this church, you know what we're going to say to you every time you walk through those doors? God forgives you. But the Lord said this, neither do I condemn thee, but go and sin no more. What he's saying, don't go out no more. I forgive you. I don't condemn you. I'm forgiving you. But my forgiveness is conditional, not on what you can do for God. You can't do nothing. But stay in the Lord Jesus Christ. That's all you got to do. Isn't that good? Isn't that wonderful? You don't have to work for it. You don't have to earn it. You just have to abide in it. Just build you a house. Some of you in here walking God for a long time, you've got about a 30-story. Been here a long time building for God. People, how long you been in here? Boy, a long time. Yeah, yeah. I've been building. Did you ever want to chase servants out those doors, Brother Bill? Sure I did. Oh, I got right to the brink at times. Oh, come on, somebody. But I stayed. I'm still forgiven. Living like I'm forgiven. Here this morning with every head bowed and every eye closed, maybe the devil, maybe you've got servants, maybe you've got things that were very much a part of your life that are bolting on you in this season of life. You feel them bolting. They've always been a part of your life. They've always been there. They've always helped you as servants do. They've always supported you. But now they've bolted out of Jerusalem. These people, or maybe in your own self, they've bolted and the devil's trying to convince you to just go after them. Cross Kindron again. Just go after and get them and you can be back next Sunday. But listen, count it all loss, all done for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ. Folks, I can tell you, there's been many times I've wanted to run out those gates and chase down servants and beat them to a pulp. But I've realized nothing's worth this great salvation of God. There's no anger, there's no bitterness, there's no hurt, there's no pain, there's no money. But to know God and to live in His forgiveness. If you're here this morning and you say, Pastor, this message is for me. I'm being tempted to chase after things that God has released out of Jerusalem. But this morning, I want to reestablish myself in permanency and within the walls of Jerusalem. Around this building, lift up your hand. God's talking to you. Come on now, be honest. God's talking to you. Don't chase it. Don't chase it. Hands going up. There's still more of you. Pastor, I need this. Hands. There's things that devils want me to chase, to leave this place of salvation and forgiveness. But here this morning, I'm going to say once and for all, let the servants go. I'm abiding in Christ all the days of my life. Around this building, these altars are open. Come, come. Let's get a hold of God. Let's release some things. Let's count it all but lost. Let's say, Lord, I'm going to abide in You. It doesn't matter the pain. I know the devil's trying to get me to chase this and chase that and chase this and go after that. But here this morning, I'm going to freshly commit myself to an eternal life in the city of Jerusalem. God bless you as you come.